Ooh, Kevin Fiala is back with the Wild. He recently, a couple days ago, signed. I didn't make a video on it just because I'd made a couple videos in the Wild offseason, and this was known it was going to happen. But I have a video idea today to talk about it, to get it involved. So, yeah, Kevin Fiala and the Wild were headed to arbitration this past week, but before they could get there, they ended up agreeing on a contract that kind of avoided the awkwardness of arbitration. Contract was a one-year deal worth $5.1 million, which Fiala, Kevin Fiala, entering the offseason was most likely, I think, known now that he wanted to kind of ink a long-term contract, one that would set him up in a Wild uniform for years to come. Unfortunately for him and for me, because I do love Kevin Fiala, that's not the case, as we know. It's a salary cap league. It's hard because the Wild are going to have a shit ton of dead cap. How do they deal with it? But yeah, right now, one-year deal. Clearly he didn't get the long-term deal he wanted, so the hope is that morale will not be hit hard for him. This isn't NHL 22 franchise mode, where the ideal scenario is always to just go the cheapest option that saves your team the most money and, you know, you can do whatever the hell you want. Sometimes you gotta do what your star players want, make your star players happy, and obviously one star player, Kirill Kaprizov, not too happy. I think that's more his fault than Guerin's. But yeah, Kevin Fiala, the other one, gets a one-year deal rather than the 5 or 6 that he wanted. Not ideal. Not ideal, Bill Guerin not really keeping him what I would assume is the happiest right now, but honestly, there's only so much you can do. He wanted a 5-year deal, 5-6, he gets one, $5.1 million, he thinks he's worth that, or worth more than that, so not great for him. Now, this can go one of kind of two ways. Maybe he plays really pissed off and does well, or he goes pissed off and doesn't play well. I think it'll be the first option. I think he'll play well, I think he'll do alright. But yeah, they went to arbitration because it basically sets a deadline and guarantees Fiala will be back. And he is. So what did general manager Billy Guerin, Billy G, have to say about the Kevin Fiala one-year deal? Here's about a minute or so of him talking and just kind of explaining his stance on it.
Do you think this will be a big, you know, important year for him so you can work on maybe signing him long-term next summer when he's got 1 year left before unrestricted free agency?
Yeah, I do. I think it's a very important year for him. I mean, anytime you're in a contract year, it's very important. It's, you know, if Kevin truly wants to establish himself as an elite player, then, you know what, he's going to have to keep improving. And, you know, he's had 2 good years for us and, you know, he's going to have to continue to get better. You know, Kevin's still young too. He's still, he's still a young man and, there's lots of room for improvement in his game on a lot of different areas, but there are some things that he does extremely well that other people in the league can't do. And, like I said, it's a big year for him. Always.
All right. So there you go. Billy G, Billy Guerin kind of talking about it. So now what? Now where do we go from here? Kevin Fiala, is he going to be pissed off? I think he maybe, but that could be good. I hope he plays pissed off in a good way, plays up pissed off in a what is a prove-it year for him, for Kevin Fiala, instead of pissed off and going, well, I don't want to play here, which I don't think he will do. I think he's a good guy. I think he knows that it's a prove-it year for him. Play like you deserve that 5-year contract. Play like you deserve $6 million a year. I think he wants 6.5 in arbitration, 6.1. Around there, but he wanted at least 6 mil. But it's tough for him, because Fiala's good. He's really good, obviously. I mean, you don't get 5 mil by being bad, especially in a salary cap league like NHL here. Kevin Fiala, he's good in the box score, which is why he got $5 million. But it's tough for him, because I think outside of it, the reason he's worth more but didn't get more, if this makes sense, is because he's good outside of the box score. You know, in contract negotiations, general manager can go, hey, well, he scored blah 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 goals and blah 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 points. And the arbiter, who's just a guy, goes, well, all right, you're right, he's worth this much rather than what he's truly worth to the team, which is, I think, more than that. I think no one on the team, on the Wild, sets up their, okay, maybe Kirill, but he's Kirill. It's very difficult for anyone to approach the level of passing that Kevin Fiala gets you. The way he can set up his teammates, the way he scores, the way he just gets scoring chance after scoring chance. We saw in the playoffs, he couldn't come through, but he was the only guy really showing off. He was one of the few doing well. He was looking real good. Didn't get the points to show it, because of course. And that's a prime example. Outside of the box score, tons of chances, ton of passing, a lot of good stuff. And, you know, he did have a lot of points. He had 20 points, 20 assists for 40 points, 50 games. Plus minus of -2. And last year, -1. That doesn't help, but that's not his fault. He played, his most common line mates were Marcus Johansson, and Ryan Hartman. Marcus Johansson, in terms of wins above replacement and goals above replacement, literally the worst on the Wild by a large margin. That's not Fiala's fault. He got stuck with a very poor hand in terms of line mates. What's he supposed to do? I mean, what are you going to do? I don't know. It's tough for him because he deserves more for what he does outside the box score. But a salary cap strapped team like the Wild can go, hey, once you score more, once you produce more, once you're in 20, you got to get more than 20 or 23 and 64 games in 2019. It sucks. I think he's worth more, and it is what it is. But hopefully, being paired with, I think this upcoming season, he should have a Matthew Boldy on the other wing side and a center of either Frederick Goudreau or Ryan Hartman again, which is fine. I think the biggest thing is replacing Marcus Johansson. Getting Matthew Boldy in there, who's young, up and coming, and is going to be a nice goal scorer, a nice point scorer alongside Fiala, I think is a very good move. The center is tough. They didn't really bring in any difference makers, but Goudreau could be all right. Fiala knows Hartman enough. I think the two of them have forged a good enough of a connection, but Johansson was dragging down the line. That's just what it is. I am very excited to see him play this year. I think he's going to be playing pissed off, trying to prove it, trying to get that long-term deal that hopefully he can get. And that's a whole nother story. Can the Wild even make that work financially? Whole nother video there for another time, because that's not for a year from now. But long story short, maybe not. But for this year, they've got him under contract, 5 mil. Nice. Playing with Matthew Boldy, probably Ryan Hartman. Can you make that work? I think so. I'm very excited to see him, Matthew Boldy, Kirill Kaprizov, Joel Eriksson-Ek, and the rest of the Wild. It's going to be a fun year. I would love for them to bring in another center, but it seems very unlikely. Fiala might even have to be the parting piece if they do, so we'll see. But let me know. What do you think? You like Kevin Fiala? Think he's worth more? Think he's worth less? More years? Less years? That wouldn't make any sense. But yeah, let me know in the comments, and go check out yesterday's Twins video. It was good. All right. That's about all I got for today. Peace.